إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار قال الله تعالى وأذن في الناس بالحج يأتوك رجالا وعلى كل ضامر يأتين من كل فج عميق ليشهدوا منافع لهم Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is commanding the prophets, starting with Ibrahim alayhi salam, to proclaim Hajj, to call upon them to come to perform Hajj in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they will respond. They will come on foot and on every lean camel from far away, distant valleys. Why? لِيَشْهَدُوا مَنَافِعَ لَهُمْ In order for them to witness things which are of benefit for them. الحج has a lot of benefits, brothers and sisters in Islam. Rabbul Alameen speaks about those who are able physically and financially to go, and they do not go. Indeed, they are deprived. في سنن الإمام البيهقي حديث أبي سعيد الخدري رضي الله عنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says قال الله تعالى الله سبحانه وتعالى says إن عبدا أصححت له جسمه وأوسعت عليه في رزقه تمر عليه خمس أعوام لا يفد إلي لمحروم A servant of mine, I made him healthy. I given him wealth. He allows 5 years to pass without coming to me in my house. Indeed, he is deprived. Deprived from the forgiveness that a person may earn by performing this pillar, provided that he did it sincerely and according to the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم من حج فلم يرفث ولم يفسق رجع من ذنوبه كيوم ولدته أمه. Whosoever performs Hajj without any violation, he will come back like a newborn. وقال لعمر بن العاص حين أسلم, and he said صلى الله عليه وسلم to عمر بن العاص رضي الله عنه, when he became a Muslim, كما في صحيح مسلم, والحج يجب ما قبله, and Hajj, ya Amr, erases all the sins before it. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم الحج المبرور ليس له ثواب إلا الجنة. أنا مبرور حج, an accepted Hajj has no other reward but Jannah. وقال صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في مسند أحمد من حديث ابن مسعود تابعوا بين الحج والعمرة فإنهما ينفيان الفقر والذنوب كما ينفي الكير خبث الحديد والذهب والفضة. Follow Hajj after Umrah because this will cleanse you from sins and poverty. There is a hadith that is so amazing, and just to show you, if you're able to go physically and financially and you do not do it, you're really depriving yourselves from whole a lot. Brothers and sisters in Islam, هذا الحديث مخرج في المعجم الكبير للإمام الطبراني وأيضا صحيح ابن حبان من حديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنهما. ابن عمر, the narrator of the hadith, says كنت جالسا مع رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في مسجد منى. I was sitting with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the masjid of Mina during the days of Hajj. فأتاه رجلان, two companions, they showed up. أحدهما من الأنصار, one of them is Ansari, والآخر من ثقيف, and the other one ثقفي, from a tribe called ثقيف. فسلم, they said السلام عليك يا رسول الله, and then they sat down in front of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And the Thaqafi spoke and he said, Ya Rasulallah, O Messenger of Allah, جئنا نسألك, we came to ask you. Then the Prophet ﷺ said, hold on, I can tell you what you came to ask about, if you want me to. If you don't want me to, I will stay silent and you can go ahead and ask. صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال بل أخبرنا يا رسول الله. Tell us, O Messenger of Allah, نزداد إيمانا ويقينا, in order to increase in إيمان and certainty. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, you came asking about your reward for leaving your homes and coming all the way and making tawaf around the Kaaba, and you came asking your reward for praying two rak'ahs before the station of Ibrahim, Maqam Ibrahim, alayhi salam. And you came to ask your reward for making tawaf, sa'i, between the Safa and Marwa. And you came to ask about your reward for standing on the mountain of Arafah until after the sun sets. And you came to ask about your reward for slaughtering on the day of Eid. And you came to ask about your reward for shaving your heads. And you came to ask about your reward for throwing the pebbles. And you came to ask about your reward for doing the farewell tawaf. قال والذي بعثك بالحق عن هذا جئنا نسأل. By the one who sent you with the truth, we came to ask about this. He said صلى الله عليه وسلم, as for you leaving your homes, coming all the way to the house of Allah, your camel does not lift a hoover, feet, and places another in the ground, except a sin erased and a hasana added. Imagine coming all the way from America. As for you praying two rak'ahs behind the maqam of Ibrahim, as if you have freed a neck from the offspring of Ismail alayhi salam. And as for your sa'i between Safa and Marwa, as if you have freed 70 necks. And as for you standing on the mountain of Arafah, on the day of Arafah, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْبِطُ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ الدُّنْيَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends to the lower heaven in a way that fits Him. We cannot comprehend how He descends. And He speaks to His angels, look at my servants, أَتَوْنِي شُعْثًا غُبْرًا. They came to me disheveled, dusted. They hoping for my Jannah. They are concerned about my fire. Bear witness, my angels, I have forgiven all their sins, even if it is as many as the drops of rain, if it is as many as the foam of the sea, if it is as many as the number of sands, pieces of sand, stones. And I have accepted their intercession for whomever they made dua for. And as for you shaving your head, every piece of hair that comes down, a sin erased, a hasana added. As for throwing the pebbles, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala expiate for each pebble one destructive sin. What are the rewards? Indeed, someone who can do it and he does not do it is deprived. Brothers and sisters in Islam, there are a lot of other benefits that a person can share with you just by observing and looking. And I'll share some with you today, inshallah. And in the lecture tomorrow, I will share a little bit more, bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. The first thing that I want to share with you is the impact of activating the law of servitude. قانون العبودية. سمعنا وأطعنا. You really observe this in Hajj. When you say سمعنا وأطعنا all the time, and how this impacts you. You really figure out that right here, you're looking for happiness in the wrong places. We're seeking, all of us are seekers of happiness. You want to be happy. You really, Hajj shows you the real meaning of happiness. Seriously, by activating that law, سمعنا وأطعنا. Take your clothes off. Put your two garments in. سمعنا وأطعنا. Sleep here this night. سمعنا وأطعنا. Kiss the truck. سمعنا وأطعنا. Stone the truck. سمعنا وأطعنا. Make 7 rounds. سمعنا وأطعنا. Walk this way. سمعنا وأطعنا. Sleep here tonight. سمعنا وأطعنا. ما في why and ما في. It's too costly to say why. And you feel this. You feel the happiness, the real meaning of happiness. Happiness is not about the clothes that you wear, or about the car that you drive, or the house that you live in. No, it's not that. You're mistaken if you think you're going to find happiness. If you take that route as a seeker of happiness, you're going to be like somebody who drinks salty water. You keep drinking, but you're still thirsty. You're never going to be happy. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس الغنى عن كثرة العرض ولكن الغنى غنى النفس. يعني يا إخوة, في night, there is a night في الحج called the night of المزدلفة. Right after coming down from the mountain of Arafah, you're supposed to sleep in the ground. In the ground, wearing dirty filthy clothes. هكذا رب العالمين يقول أتوني شعفا غبرا. They came to me dusted, disheveled. والله, I swear by Allah, the happiest night in the life of a Hajj, that night. Sleeping in the ground. Looking up there, just... That's what Islam came to do for you. Not just in Hajj. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا استجيبوا استجيبوا لله وللرسول إذا دعاكم لما يحييكم. We believe, respond, say سمعنا وأطعنا to Allah and His Messenger because they are calling you to what will give you life, real life. حتى physical يا أخي, you do a lot of work in Hajj out of this world. It tells you also that when your iman, because you got to understand this, as much as you do of obedience to Allah and staying away from the disobedience of Allah, your iman increases. Your iman increases. Iman increases and decreases. يزيد بالطاعة, increases through the obedience of Allah and decreases through the disobedience of Allah. That affects you physically. You find yourself running, walking like a horse. And you actually start when your iman drops, when you go back home after Hajj. Your iman drops because you're not doing as much as you used to do during Hajj. You start feeling the physical consequences of what you've been doing before. This is the real meaning that Hajj brings to those who go to Hajj. People sitting in the ground, sleeping in tents, but they are happy because they are activating the law of servitude, the law of servitude which they are supposed to activate anyways during the course of their lives. قانون العبودية يا إخوة. سمعنا وأطعنا. Say سمعنا وأطعنا to the commands of Allah, and Allah will make you happy in this world. Don't seek happiness in the resources in earth. Happiness in the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Another lesson that in Hajj, subhanallah, you go to Hajj, people you never met in your life before. And they are probably from a different country, different culture, different language. And you fall in love with them. You find that affection. Ulf. Subhanallah. الأرواح جنود مجندة. فما تعارف منها ائتلف وما تنافر منها اختلف. And you wonder why? Why you find yourself befriending or becoming a friend of somebody you just spent with him a couple of hours? Because you met for the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, we're needing this in our communities, especially in America. We need to have affection amongst ourselves, amongst the individuals of the ummah. We need to have affection amongst the members of the family. We don't have it. We don't have that harmony. But again, Hajj teaches you one lesson. That the only way you're going to unite with somebody, you're going to have that affection with somebody, only if you obey Allah according to the sunnah of the Messenger of Allah. That's it. Don't even think about it, that you can unite people at the expense of disobeying Allah and His Messenger. It's a fake unity. It's a unity of interest. اتحاد مصالح. Mutual interest. Do this for me, do this for you. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He spoke to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَإِن يُرِيدُوا أَن يَخْدَعُوكَ فَإِنَّ حَسْبَكَ اللَّهُ هُوَ الَّذِي أَيَّدَكَ بِنَصْرِهِ وَبِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِهِمْ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala placed affection amongst their hearts, O Muhammad, your companions, your supporters, your helpers. No one in the face of this earth can bring hearts together but the creator of these hearts, the one who holds these hearts. And the only way our hearts will be together, only if we obey Allah and the Messenger of Allah. Keep away culture. Keep away hearsay, religion. Keep away bid'ah. Keep away all of this from our communities. It will disunite our communities. The only thing, and I'm telling you, don't deceive yourselves. The only thing which will unite this ummah is the Quran and the Sunnah, based on the understanding of the virtuous generations of this ummah, the first three. Brothers and sisters in Islam, subhanallah, just there is something in the minds, just to give you a practical example, brothers, which we had some affection going until the day of Arafah. They came and asking me, being the imam of the group, we want to go to Jabal al-Rahmah, the mountain of al-Rahmah. فَقُلْتُ لَهُمْ, I said to them, يَا أَخِي هَذِهِ يعني مَا فِيهَا فَضْلِ يعني, there is no virtue in it. وَبْتَكْثَرْ سَوَادْ أَهْلِ الْبِدَعْ, the people go there and they touch the bid'ah. فَقُلْتُ لَهُ, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, عَرَفَ كُلُّ مَوْقِف, any place in Arafah, Alhamdulillah, just make dua. فَصَمَّمَ الرَّجُلُ, he insisted. He went and he got lost. He ended up coming to us in al-Muzdalifah. He fought, he came crying and yelling, I lost my Hajj. I had 6 fights already, trying to figure out how to come back to you. I told him, Ya Akhi, I told you, there is no virtue in this. يعني, اتبع النبي. اتبع النبي يا أخي. Don't follow the hearsay. Don't follow the... And then he tells me, well, everybody is doing it. The mountain was filled with people. يا أخي, وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْثَرَ مَن فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضُلُّكَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. If you follow the majority of people in earth, they will take you astray. They will misguide you. هو الدين بالأعداد. هو احنا داخلين انتخابات. This is not election. Religion is text, not hearsay. And this is what will unify the ummah. I don't want to prolong my khutbah, but just one last, maybe before last. Subhanallah, at the beginning of Hajj, normally you find the people who are high level, we call them high level in the society. Yani PhD or a doctor, or yani mashallah, he's having a comfy life. As soon as they arrive, the first couple of days before Hajj, they kind of struggle. I want to stay this way, you know, I want to stay this way. And they keep asking you these questions about, Wallahi ya ikhwa, subhanallah, as soon as they take these dunya clothes off, and they change to those two garments, which are very similar to al-ihram, similar to the al-kafan, the shroud, subhanallah. يعني, whatever you do, by the way, whatever you wear, whatever you drive, impacts you. إِلَّا مَنْ رَحِمَ رَبِّي يعني. يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says, أهل الكبر أهل الخيل والإبل وأهل السكينة أهل الغنم. You will find the majority of the people who ride horses are arrogant. And the people who shepherd are humble. Why? Look at the face of a horse. You know, he looks at this face. And look at the face of a goat. You will cry. If you really look and focus in the face of a goat, you will cry. Man, so miserable. Impact you. Whatever you're wearing can deceive you. Whatever the people make of you can deceive you. But what really matters at the end of the day, who are you in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Who are you? This is must be your concern, brothers and sisters in Islam. People can make your head big. People can place you in a position that is not yours. And you will believe them. It was said that somebody was holding in his hand, A'azzakumullah, the feces of a camel. And it looks like normally a date. Nice date. So the people passing by, nice date. Looks at it. Nice date. At the end, he ate it. He believed it. Worry about who you are in the sight of Allah, brothers and sisters in Islam. This is what matters. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله. A feeling, brothers and sisters in Islam, that hit you after completing Hajj is the feeling of death, is dying. You feel like you have achieved, hoping that Allah accepted you, and hoping that if you go now, maybe is the ideal time. And subhanAllah, this happens every year almost. And this year I was just trying to find whether that feeling is something that is legitimate or what is this is about. And I came across athar, يعني مخرج في البخاري, and also with Ibn al-Dhahhak and Imam al-Fadali. A combination of two. That when Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu threw the last pebbles, one of the last rituals of Hajj before the farewell tawaf is you throw the pebbles, the third yom of Tashriq. Yaqul Aslam, Mawlah, his servant. Then he moved a little bit ahead, وَأَنَاخَ نَاقَتَهُ, and he came down from his camel, and he placed his rida on the ground, and then he sat on it, وَرَفَعَ يَدَيْهِ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ, and he raised his hand and he said, he made this dua. Hafsa also was with him, his daughter, أُمُّ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهَا. قال, he said, اللهم كبر سني وكثرت رعيتي فتوفني إليك غير مفرط. Oh Allah, I'm getting old. I'm getting old. And my ra'iyya is expanding. الإسلام يا إخوة في عهد عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله عنه reached places, a lot of places in earth. He's basically saying that this is an amana. I cannot keep up with it because my health, I'm getting old. Oh Allah, توفني إليك غير مفرط. Take me before I waste. طبعا النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم نهانا عن تمني الموت. He banned us from asking to die. And he told us to say, Oh Allah, make us live if life is good for us, and make us die if death is good for us. You leave it to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا يتمنن أحدكم الموت لضرر أصابه ولكن إن كان فليقل اللهم أحيني ما علمت الحياة خيرا لي وتوفني ما علمت الوفاة خيرا لي. And then he said, Oh Allah, make me die as a shaheed in the town of your messenger, Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Hafsa, subhanallah, she said, How is that? How are you going to die as a shaheed in the town of the Prophet? In order to die as a shaheed, you have to go to the battlefields. يقول سعيد بن المسيب وهو من رواة هذا الأثر, one of the people who narrated it, فوالله, by Allah, ما مرد الحجة, the الحجة did not end until Umar was stabbed in the Salah. Abu Lu'lu' al-Majusi stabbed him when he was leading Salat al-Fajr, reciting Surah Yusuf wal-Nahl in the Salah. الشاهد يعني عمر made this dua when? At this time. You know, something that I shared with the people who were in Hajj with me, I told them, don't expect yourselves that you're going to be Mr. Righteous or Mrs. Righteous when you return. لا. كل ابن آدم خطاء. All of us are sinners. You're going to sin again. And probably Shaytan is going to get you in trouble right away to show you that, look, you're not meant to be a good person. I told you. But now you know what to do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends on the people of al-mawqif in Arafah. Do you know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends every single night? كما في الصحيح, حديث أبي موسى, when the last third of the night is here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends and he says, anybody wants forgiveness? Anyone wants tawbah? You can just wake up and pray tahajjud and ask Allah to forgive you. Keep up with the salah. Keep up with the law of servitude. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will cleanse your record as you go. Inshallah, tomorrow between Maghrib and Isha, if Allah gives the health, we will share some more insights about Hajj, inshallah. I just arrived last night and I just thought about sharing this with you. And I hope, inshallah, this will motivate you to go. Don't deprive yourselves, brothers and sisters in Islam. By the way, all it takes is an intention. Wallahi, I have experienced it. An intention that you want to go next year. And you will see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make it possible for you. But because no one goes without the permission of Allah, you must be invited. فإنشاءالله, make the intention today before you leave, right now, that you want to go next year, inshaAllah, to make Hajj, to go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in His house, so that you get some of these benefits. اللهم اكتب لنا حجا وعمرة يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا من حجاج بيتك يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم تقبل منا صلاتنا وحجنا وزيارتنا لبيتك الحرام يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وإسرافنا في أمرنا، وثبت أقدامنا وانصرنا على القوم الكافرين. اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه، وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه. اللهم استعملنا ولا تستبدلنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى يا أكرم الأكرمين. اللهم اجعلنا دعاة لدينك يا أرحم الراحمين، ولهدي وسنة نبيك يا أكرم الأكرمين. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم، وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة، قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر، الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
استقيموا، استووا، استقيموا. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. لقد جاءكم رسول من أنفسكم عزيز عليه ما عنتم، عزيز عليه ما عنتم، حريص عليكم بالمؤمنين رؤوف رحيم. فإن تولوا فقل حسبي الله، فقل حسبي الله لا إله إلا هو، عليه توكلت، وهو رب العرش العظيم. الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. يسألونك عن الساعة أيان مرساها، فيما أنت من ذكراها، إلى ربك منتهاها، إنما أنت منذر من يخشاها، كأنهم يوم يرونها لم يلبثوا إلا عشية أو ضحاها.